to Friday Night Basketball on 2K Sports. And tonight, we've got Denver playing against Dallas. This is Brian Anderson at the table with basketball royalty, Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg, Allie LaForce, our reporter. Now the starting group for the visitors. We've got Grant Williams. Luka Doncic is out there with Kyrie Irving. Then it's Tim Hardaway, and it's Powell in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And for the Nuggets, Aaron Gordon is out there with Michael Porter. Then there's Nikola Jokic. Then it's Murray. And it's Caldwell Pope in at the two spot. Well, Grant, this is the type of game that may look lopsided, but as we've seen, anything can happen.
Anything can definitely happen, B.A. And look, you have to understand that every guy in this league is talented. If you come in flat and those other guys are inspired, you can fall. But honestly, you shouldn't. It's all about handling your business.
Now here's Murray. Here's Jokic. Yes, and it's Murray picking up the assist.
I don't know if this is one of Jokic's preferred spots, but his smooth stroke allows him to cash in from anywhere.
Now Doncic. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
Well, I'm gonna credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays down.
Now here's Murray. Left side, Caldwell Pope. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
I think it's important that Caldwell Pope makes these shots, showing real toughness, converting through contact.
Williams against Gordon. Left side, Williams. Powell outside. Five on the clock. Doncic with it. And Jokic picks him up defensively. Luka Doncic again.
Trying to knock Luka off his game, distract him and frustrate him, but he just plays through contact like it's not there.
Caldwell Pope, the pass to Gordon. And here's Murray. The three ball on target from range.
Three out of three, perfect start. Let's see how long they can ride this wave.
Here in the first quarter, with about 2 minutes gone by, that one's good from Powell on the assist by Irving.
Yeah, Powell showing you right there that he can play through contact. Very physical and good concentration, too, to get that up and down.
You know, when you think about Kyrie Irving's game, his ball handling is what still comes to mind first.
Yeah, you know, B.A., that and his killer instinct. Kyrie is one of the most creative players we've ever seen. A guy you can count on to come through in big moments.
Now, here's Williams. Pass to Doncic. Hardaway with it. Launches it from deep. Unable to get that one.
Would you say testing the limits of his range there?
You know, guys, I think he's got confidence to shoot it from anywhere, but he could have gotten a better one than that.
The plan coming in is working. They're perfect 5 for 5 from the floor.
And Dallas calls time here. You know, we hear the term point forward a lot. Clark, is it fair to call Nikola Jokic a point center?
I don't have any issues with it, B.A. I mean, he facilitates as a big guy with the ball in his hands like a guard at times. So point center works, but he's more than that. He's your two-time MVP is what he is.
Now here's Williams. Up and over Gordon. And it's good as he snugs it right through the net.
Not the most effective pick, but he salvages the play with a terrific move.
And here's Murray. His last outing, he had 18 points. Caldwell Pope. That one drops, and it comes off an assist from Porter. Caldwell Pope's got his second basket of the game. First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Doncic with it. His last outing, he had 18 points. To the middle. And Powell with the stuff.
Got to give it up for Powell now. I mean, he excels at rising off the ground to punch home these alley-oops.
Oh, there's the alley! And Jokic throws it down.
Well, Jokic always in sync with his teammates, which is part of why he's able to put together these highlight reel sequences.
Williams finds Powell. Now here's Hardaway. Let's it fly. Plenty of room to knock down that one. And so it's Murray who brings up the ball for Denver. 3-point lead.
And while they were regarded as the better team, they actually lost the season series last year. Of course, matchups play a big part in that.
Yeah, sometimes matchups do, but I don't think they're interested in looking at that. They want to come back strong and show they're the better team this time around.
Now here's Doncic. Well, Clark, when you talk about Doncic, he came into the league with a ton of experience under his belt.
And I think people undervalued the experience of being a pro at the age of 16. It wasn't the NBA, but it's still professional basketball that he played in Europe. And that seasoning and that competition and that being refined in the fire allowed Doncic to step into the NBA unfazed.
Misses. Well, Clark, being that we're early in the season, what would you say to teams that have gotten off to rough starts?
Well, I think you've got to keep your eye on the big picture, Brian. I mean, the season has just started, and there's plenty of time to get things right. No reason to panic. You got to stay even keeled here.
Good on the second one.
Luka Doncic is a do-it-all player. I mean, he does everything for this team, including being a walking triple-double threat on a game-by-game basis.
Gordon, the pass to Watson. Ooh, the lead pass was in the perfect spot to set up the layup.
I tell you what, it reminds me of one of my college coaches who used to say, that ain't gonna get it done. That's five straight baskets in the paint now.
Now here's Doncic. He's got five. The three. Brown grabs the board. Here's Jackson, and he buries his first look.
And was determined to get in there. Jackson in with the big boys.
Here's Hardy. Count it. One for one to start the game.
The defense kind of opened up for him, and he took full advantage.
Doncic against Jackson. And that one makes him two for two. He's in his rhythm.
Man, that's now 10 straight points in the paint.
I'm not sure what's happened to their defense, man.
I think they've really got to start committing more bodies down low and really kind of close that area off defensively.
From deep, here's Doncic. Hits a three-pointer. Doncic has got his third basket on the night right there. Doncic has got three of his four shots to fall, hitting 75%. Now a timeout called by Denver.
Adjustments are a part of every game and every quarter of a game. I think Coach sees something here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
And now a look back at last year's top shooting teams in the NBA. Number one, Denver.
Tremendous efficiency on offense. They were willing to put in their work to get great looks.
We've got 1:55 left to play in the first. Brown passes to Jackson. Here's Brown. Six on the shot clock. Here's Gordon. Nice start for him. Sinking his first shot.
And talk about imposing your will. That's 10 straight points in the paint.
Well, constantly finding lanes to the basket, getting great looks inside.
Now here's Green. No made baskets yet. And he lobs it up to the rim. To the inside. Here's Gordon. Two shots, two makes. Off to a good start.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Poke loose. Green, the pass to Powell. Back to Green. Doncic against Jackson. Doncic's shot is good. Doncic has got 10 points in the game.
Nothing the D could do there. No way to stop Doncic. He's so hard to guard.
Jackson, the pass to Brown. Jackson on the wing, guarded by Doncic. And the shot's good. He's got six.
The big story thus far, how well they've shot the rock.
Very high percentage so far, and if you want to start a game hot, that's the way to do it.
And Gordon has got the ball here for the Nuggets. 9-point game.
Yeah, we know that on the road, you're already a little out of your element. Then the misses from the line become contagious.
And, you know, one of the things about missing free throws is not only are you not getting points yourself, but it allows the other team to maintain momentum or keep a rally going.
Here's Jackson. No good. Misses at the buzzer. The baskets were coming early and often in the first quarter. Leading by 9. And the second quarter is on its way when we return. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Nuggets.
Everything working for them inside so far, guys. Tons of high-quality shots that they're knocking down inside.
And another thing, they've been on the attack tonight, going right at defenders with the ball in their hands early.
Here's Doncic. On the court right now for Dallas. Luka Doncic is out there with Kyrie Irving. Then there's Grant Williams. Then there's Maxi Kleba. And it's Hardaway in at the small forward position. Now here's Hardaway. They trail by 9. Here's Williams. Williams cleaning up the miss.
And once more this half, they find a way to get great position inside.
A moment to hear from Ali LaForce.
Brian, the last 5 MVP awards have gone to foreign players. Nikola Jokic told me, I think we're showing that there is a lot more talent in the world. It's not just USA. And I think that's the beauty. We are giving all the kids a chance and an opportunity to see that they can make it. B.A.?
I love that story. Outstanding. Thanks, Ali. Jokic has gone 3 for 3 from the floor. Porter against Hardaway. Up and over Porter. And that one off the back of the rim and in. Hardaway's got his second basket.
Boy, a promising mid-range game that's highlighted by strong fundamentals and mechanics. Hardaway Jr., a productive scorer.
Now here's Caldwell Pope. We saw him with 11 points in his last game. 6 to shoot. Count it. Good. Caldwell Pope's got 6.
Look at Caldwell Pope battling inside. Boy, he fights through that contact, doesn't he?
Doncic passes to Irving. Back to Doncic. Oh, Luka, like a bull in there.
Great assist that time by Kyrie Irving.
Doncic has gone 6 of 8 from the field. Outside, Caldwell Pope to the paint. Oh, and makes it with the kiss. Porter's got his second basket of the night.
Converting through contact. Porter Jr. showing you how relentless he can be on offense.
Here's Doncic. Doncic punches it home.
What a finish. I mean, he just took over himself.
What a show of power right there from the point guard. Man, sweet.
And you know, guys, when your point guard is making explosive plays at the rim, I really do think it sets the tone for the rest of the team.
Jokic, good.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Doncic with the bucket.
Luka Doncic with the 3-point answer. As competitive as they come.
Pass to Jokic. No stopping Jokic in the paint.
And he's coming off a huge performance, and his confidence couldn't be any higher. And his coach knows that, too.
Showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. They're going to ride him as far as he can take him.
And Dallas calls time here. And they say small ball is on the rise. But you look at the MVPs of late, Clark, a lot of superstar bigs.
Yeah, that's a great point, B.A. I mean, Embiid, Jokic, Giannis, I mean, with the floor spaced, I think it's freed up everybody that has ball skills to be able to make plays. And a lot of these guys are north of 7 feet that are doing it, whether it's off the dribble or pass and catch or knocking down mid-range and long-range shots. I think it's added to the versatility of stars in the game, the different positions where you can star from because of how the game is played now.
Holiday's checked in for Gordon. Let's see the stat sheet here for Kyrie Irving. Now here's Hardaway. Pass to Kleba. Fires for three. And he buries his first look.
Well, you know, guys, we know Hardaway can score, but when he makes these passes, it makes him a lot more dangerous.
Hey, yo, right here!
Caldwell Pope against Irving. Caldwell Pope, the pass to Jokic. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play opportunity.
One shot.
You know, what makes Jokic truly exceptional in my mind is the versatility. You know, he's a really good passer, and that to me is a tremendous distinction, not to mention how he scores and does the other stuff he does out there.
Now, here's Williams. Outside Curry. Let's go with a three. Gets the three to fall. Curry's gotten himself going here. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Murray passes to Jokic. Now Holiday. Back to Jokic. Kleba with a steal. Curry looking it over. Irving, the pass to Hardaway. Back to Irving. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. Irving's got his first 2 points. The Nuggets have gotten each of their 6 shots to fall here in the second. Murray passes to Caldwell Pope. It's good. Caldwell Pope's got 8 points.
They're not messing around. 5 of their last 6 buckets have come from the interior.
Right side, Hardaway. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Curry.
This is Hardaway's game, a quick trigger shooter who wants to score as often as possible.
And if you're looking for a knockdown shooter from distance, look no further than Seth Curry.
Well, not many guys have hit over 40% from three for their careers. And Seth Curry is in that exclusive club. And as a huge bonus, he protects the basketball and doesn't turn it over.
Now here's Curry. In his last outing, he had 11 points. Yes, it's good.
A precision passer, Curry, also excellent at seeing his guys when they're open.
The Nuggets have gotten all 8 shots to go. A perfect second quarter so far. Pass to Jokic. Down low. Murray. Played it in with a nice touch off the window. He's got 9.
And guys, the way this defense is getting manhandled down low, you have to wonder if they're at 100% right now.
And Dallas calls time here. ACL injuries are always a scary thing in this league, Clark. It sidelined Jamal Murray for a full 18 months.
So tough for a player to lose that kind of time, B.A., but Murray really is a tough guy. And he focused on his recovery and was able to make a strong return to the court.
So both teams changing it up here. And always interesting to look back at last season. These were the NBA's best transition teams. Denver in 5th.
You know, it really made for some exciting games the way this team ran the floor. always maintaining impressive energy in transition.
Now here's Hardaway. Defense is right there. Blocked! Powell against Jokic. Over Powell. Off the window. It's good. Jokic has got 18.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. They should continue to ride the hot hand.
And there's the lob. Trying to go for a lob there. Excellent defense and anticipation to stop it. Brown's shot is good. And now a 10-point Denver lead.
This is intelligent basketball. Forcing a turnover and then immediately starting the fast break.
Hardaway finds Curry. Basket's good. Curry's got 5 points now this quarter.
How about the level of concentration by Seth Curry? Even when he's guarded in the paint, his focus is on the basket.
Here he goes. Curry with a steal. On the break. Here's Hardy. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Curry. Curry's got 3 assists in the game.
High basketball IQ on display from Curry there, making a quick pass.
Holiday with the ball. Now guarded by Curry. Here's Hardaway. A quick look, no good that time. And so Jokic will bring it up for the Nuggets. They've led by as many as 11. Count that bucket. Najee's got his first points of the game.
Sensational ball movement there. When you pass the ball like that, good things happen.
Just 1 second separating the shot clock and the game clock. Now Hardaway. 6 points for him. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Puts it up from the high post. And so it's Denver, finishing the quarter with an 8-point lead. And it's mostly due to their superb shooting. They've wasted very few possessions. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Thanks a lot, guys. I'm here alongside Coach Malone. And Coach, a strong first half for this team. What was clicking for you?
I love that ball movement, taking care of the ball. And that's something we've been harping on. Make a play for somebody else. And I thought we had many examples of that.
Got to help yourself. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Allie. After the break, we'll see you right back here to begin quarter number 3.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Greetings to each and every one of you watching at this very moment. I'm Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is here. Shaq is here. One half is behind us. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Some incredible work in this one by Nikola Jokic. He had 18 points, 2 assists, and 2 rebounds. He's really stood out for them to this point. And, big fella, let's get your thoughts on the home team.
Ball movement was a real factor for them offense. They played unselfishly with patience. The guys got shots in their favorite spots. Get those opportunity looks, good things in the happen.
How about you, Kenny? What did you think about the visiting team?
The energy on D stood for disappointment. They were slow to rotate. Communication was bad. No effort. I mean, the intensity on that end of the floor, where it needs to be, was just not there.
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take you down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my man, Joel.
Joel, what up?
And we played through the first half. Plenty of basketball left in this one. Boy, really an incredible game here from Luka Doncic.
They've leaned on him to provide a lot of offense, and that's how he likes it.
And you know what? They've come at him a few different ways defensively, and nothing has slowed him down.
Dallas is shooting 76%. You don't see this often. Michael Porter out there with Aaron Gordon. Then there's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Then there's Jamal Murray. And it's Jokic in at center, filling out the middle. Doncic. Oh, Luka inside, just finding a way.
And, you know, you look at Doncic for a forward, this guy handles the ball extremely well. He's terrific at creating for himself off the dribble.
And for Dallas, they've got Seth Curry, Grant Williams out there with Dwight Powell. And then it's Kyrie Irving, and it's Doncic in at the one.
Woo! Defensively, you can't afford to let him get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
You know, you look at it, the communication is lacking, as is the trust. They can ill afford those types of breakdowns. It won't work. You can't win with those kind of breakdowns.
Now here's Murray. Connects on the open jumper. And now it's a 10-point Denver lead.
I mean, some good stuff out here. Five of their last six buckets have come off of nice passes.
From deep, here's Doncic. Wow, deep shot from Luka.
It always seems like Doncic is playing with something to prove. Well, I'll tell you what, he's proving plenty tonight.
Murray against Doncic. Pulls it. Murray's shot is good. Murray's got 13.
His efficiency has been a big factor in helping them capture this lead.
Gordon against Williams. Outside Irving. Just five on the clock. Doncic outside. From deep three-point range. Porter pulls it in. The Nuggets have gone 3 of 3 in the second half. Outside Murray. Bad intentions. And he makes no mistake. Slam dunk. Once again, an explosive highlight on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. And Dallas calls time here.
There's just a lot of wide open lanes to the rim here. That'll drive your coach nuts.
And, you know, I think he's going to tell him simply, we have to show more fight on the interior. That's the top priority right now.
Green's checked in for Curry. All right, now let's have a look at who was really dominating the boards last season. Nikola Jokic is second.
Simply put, he was terrific down low last year, owning the glass.
The visitors with the ball. They trail by 11. Green, the pass to Doncic. Irving for three. Gets the three ball to go. Irving's got his third bucket of the night.
Back-to-back threes, making their defense work on the perimeter a bit.
Murray inside, guarded by Doncic. Murray passes to Gordon. Lays it up and banks it in. Gordon's got 8.
And right now, that's 5 buckets in a row, looking like a well-oiled machine coming out of the break.
Here's Williams. And Williams punches it home.
You got to appreciate Kyrie Irving's court awareness. Outstanding. Finding open teammates.
Here's Murray. And he gets it to go. Murray's got 8 points in the quarter.
They're finding ways to get the ball into the paint. 5 consecutive buckets.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Now here's Irving. He's got 7. Count it. 9 points in the game.
Hey, the skills of Kyrie are obvious, but what isn't so obvious is his underestimated strength.
Pass to Jokic. Inside. And Gordon with the basket on the assist by Jokic. And the Nuggets lead by 10. The Mavericks have gotten 5 of 8 shots to go in the third. Green up top. He's guarded by Porter. And that one's good. Green.
Good work shaking free of the defense and finding his shot.
And he lobs it up top. And Gordon with the big finish.
Nobody does it better than Gordon on the alley-oop. Boom!
Pass to Williams. Back to Doncic. To the paint. And Powell with the stuff.
The pass, the catch, the slam. What a clean play.
Man, absolutely jaw-dropping.
Tell you what, you wouldn't know they're the team trailing when they're able to pull off plays like that.
Now a timeout called by Denver.
And something fans don't always get to see.
some of the closely guarded secrets that happen in that huddle.
Yeah, typically there's some type of adjustment made out of a timeout. It might be major, or it could be just a slight tweak.
To Porter. Here's Watson. Fired to shoot. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Watson's got his second bucket of the night.
And they've really managed to dominate inside.
The play in the paint has gone almost entirely all their way.
On Saturday, they'll be matching up against DeMar DeRozan. Then on Monday, they'll go up against C.J. McCollum. And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Nuggets.
You know, all game long, they've imposed their will on the interior, scoring a lot of points
in the
painted area.
Take a break.
Well, something else that stands out is how they've shared the ball. I mean, they're getting a lot of their points from sharp passing.
That's good from Doncic. Hardaway's checked in for Williams. Perfect from the line this time. And so Jackson Jr. will bring it up for the Nuggets. They've led by as many as 11. It'll be the second game of four straight at home.
Great read to get a hand in there and disrupt the play.
And, you know, even though they didn't come up with the steal, that's still a nice defensive play.
Hardy, he's checked in for Luka Doncic. Here's Watson. He's guarded by Irving. Watson passes to Porter. Just five to shoot. Here's Watson. He's guarded by Irving. The three is up. Sends it home from three-point land. Watson's gotten his third basket of the night.
Defensively, got to close out a little faster. That's a look he'll make with regularity.
Irving finds Powell. Alley-oop up top. Hammer it home.
Tell you what, I could watch this move in this movie all night long. Irving doing a nice job getting his team quality shots.
Here's Brown. Banked it in off the glass. And the Nuggets lead by 11.
Even with the score as it is, he just keeps coming at you.
Well, he only plays one way, and that's full throttle, all day, all the time, cold-blooded and lethal. He's somebody that's really comfortable carrying the offensive load.
Pass to Porter. Here's Watson. 1:25 left in the third. Naji, good.
Not the most effective pick, but he salvages the play with a terrific move.
Hardy, the pass to Green. Powell with it. Irving for three. Brown grabs the board. Pass to Porter. Takes the assist and lays it in. Nice setup. Porter's got 6 points.
Even with the D right in his face, Porter Jr. gets it to go down. That took a lot of concentration.
He shoots it. And that one's good. Irving. Irving's got 9 points now in the second half.
Boy, he's really been dominant in this one. Unfortunately, he hasn't had much help.
Jackson outside. And he banks in the layup. Give him 8 points now.
And such a gritty player. I love how Jackson keeps his composure under duress.
Here's Hardaway. Goes back up. And the bucket is good from Powell in deep.
Second chance points are always painful. Have to make the effort to box out.
Hey, guys standing around spectating. I mean, you got to get in there and get tough.
And here is Porter. 6 points for him. A strong finish under heavy pressure from the D. Porter's gotten four this quarter.
Porter Jr. getting flashy. Check him out. Using a tricky dribble to get the best of the defender there.
And here at the end of the third, it's a double-digit ball game. They lead by 13. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on 2K Sports right after this. All right, let's listen in. Head coach Jason Kidd is mic'd up.
Contest two, right? We'll contest two to contest three, but no layup.
And Jason Kidd feeling like they need to protect the rim above all else, willing to give in on other areas.
Well, you have to take care of home base. Otherwise, it's going to be attacked all night. And that's not going to reflect well for you on the scoreboard.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. We've got Murray. Nikola Jokic is out there with Aaron Gordon. Then there's Christian Brown. And it's Watson in at the shooting guard position.
That's the shot they wanted. It just didn't fall.
You know what? That's a confidence shaker for him, though. I mean, that's a shot he expects to make every time.
And that one's good.
They're being put to the test, and he's doing everything he can to keep them in this game.
Murray passes to Jokic. Here's Brown, defended by Hardaway. Pass to Gordon. Curry against Murray. Releases. Hardaway grabs the board.
Boy, he's got to be disappointed in the result there. I mean, the defender really didn't make any impact at all.
This has been the story of the game. A battle fought on offense.
Any lull in the action so far has been short-lived because there have been nothing but buckets in this one.
Pass to Gordon. We've gone about a minute and a half into this fourth quarter. And here's Jokic. Gordon outside. And the three off target. And it's Powell with the ball for the Mavs. Here in the fourth quarter, their defense has been very strong. No baskets allowed. Williams finds Curry. Hardaway on the wing. Uses the glass on the layup.
Boy, Hardaway Jr. is a competitor now, showing you some real toughness. He's not going to give you an inch. He's going to fight you to the finish.
Now here's Jokic. Back to Murray. Let's it go from deep. The shot is good on the assist by Jokic. Jokic just got four assists in the game.
He's taking what he can get here as a three in each half.
Williams' shot is good.
Outstanding distribution there. I mean, what impressive passing ability.
Murray passes to Gordon. He gets it. He's 7 for 8 and really going at him out there.
Boy, slick pass by Murray. He makes such an effort to create for his teammates.
Here's Hardy. And the shot goes.
I like the play call. Very solid, making perfect use of the pick to get a great look.
Murray passes to Jokic. Oh, and the jam by Jokic.
And right now, Jokic has it going on. He's doing whatever he wants to out there.
Pass to Curry. And he lays it up and in.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Now here's Murray. And he drains another one. He's now 10 of 11 from the field.
You know, when Murray finishes like this, guys, it shows you how aggressive his mindset is in attacking the defense.
Williams passes to Powell. Curry with it, and Jokic picks him up defensively. Here's Powell. Oh, he remains perfect. 7 for 7, showing no signs of letting up.
Time and time again, they're creating good looks from close range.
And even under pressure in close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunities.
Here's Watson. That falls. Nice feed from Jokic. And the Nuggets lead by 10.
Such a savvy passer. Jokic is patient and gets quality openings for his teammates.
Here's Hardaway. Yes! He nails it! Hardaway's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
Well, I'm gonna credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays there.
Now a timeout called by Denver.
Adjustments are a part of every game and every quarter of a game. I think Coach sees something here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
All right, we present our New Balance player of the game, Jamal Murray.
You know, honestly, I'm a bit in shock. I mean, he couldn't miss. Just look at this stat line. You've got to really see it to believe it. Complete confidence and all-out effort from him. And, you know, he made sure this was his night. In spades.
Hey, these fans love him so much, and when he gets it going, they respond. The crowd's energy fueled his performance. And keeping us updated from the sideline, Allie LaForce.
I was able to listen in on what Denver's coach was going over with his team. He applauded their shooting and their shot selection, saying, "We're taking the right threes, not forcing anything. Keep doing that, and they'll continue to fall." Makes the game easy, doesn't it?
Okay, thank you, Allie.
You know, right there in that instance, you could see where Murray was able to take advantage of his size in that situation.
First free throw is good.
And when healthy, Murray is a force to be reckoned with, because he can go get baskets against tough defense, and he can also make plays for others.
And Murray drops them both.
Making shots at the line. You need a good routine, and he certainly has one.
Irving with it. Now here's Hardaway. And the layup is good off the glass. Hardaway's got 6 in the quarter.
Hardaway Jr., guys, doing a nice job. They're just taking what the defense gives them in the screen and roll. Good decision making.
Drops in the 3.
And looking to shoot as many 3s as possible. This kind of confidence, impressive to see.
Love the mentality there, I tell you. I know I've never coached, but, man, playing to win and being aggressive even with the lead as opposed to being safe and going into prevent offense, I'll take the former all day long. Play to win.
Here's Murray. Hardaway grabs the board. Pass to Curry. Down low. Williams. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Curry. Curry's got assist number 7 tonight. Murray scanning the floor. On the take. Soft touch off the glass. Murray's got 17 now, just in the second half.
Well, Murray not only is strong, but he's got really good speed, too, and that gets him by the defense past the contact.
Here's Irving, and the 7-footer falls.
He's been shooting with great consistency tonight. Love to see that confident play on offense.
Pass to Gordon. 1:27 left in the fourth quarter. Score that basket. His 8th out of 9 shots here today.
Defense really working hard to stop Gordon, but he's a skilled big man who knows how to use his body, especially in the paint.
And Dallas calls time here. They're trailing by 11. 1:24 left to play in the fourth. Doncic has checked in for Curry. 1:24 left in the final quarter. And he's going for the oop here. And Powell with the stuff.
Yeah, really good to see Powell playing within the offense and
taking quality shots and riding his hot hand.
Outside, Caldwell Pope. Pass to Jokic. Gordon outside. Sinks it from distance. Gordon's got 7 points here in the quarter.
And there is no way this margin gets closed down. Great execution of a game plan and a nice win here for the Nuggets.
And of course, they really dominated in the paint tonight.
They obviously came in looking to impose their will, attack the heart and soul of that defense, and it led to a lot of good looks.
And they'll chalk this up as their third win of the year.
And having this win on the books might give them a little mental advantage the next two times these squads meet.
The stats tell us that the winner of the first game is a big favorite to come out on top in the overall series.
And when you look at the game, the one thing that helped fuel this team to victory was the efficiency for Jamal Murray.
Well, the defense just couldn't figure him out, and he continued to put it to him.
Man, good whistle there.
Yeah, you could hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
Shooting two.
He hits the first one, and that brings him within single digits.
Tell you, it's so amazing to see how much raw talent Kyrie Irving has. Just seems like that ball is part of him.
Both free throws good from Irving. 24 seconds left in the fourth quarter. They can simply hold on to the ball here.
No question, B.A., they deserve the win.
And that one drops. And the Nuggets lead by 10.
Their home crowd has energized them all game. Now they're closing it out.
And I think they can start that celebration right now. I mean, what a terrific team victory.
That assertive mentality. I mean, just rising up from deep and draining it.
And so the home crowd treated to a win. This one was in the balance right until the final seconds.
And B.A., they showed their character when it mattered most, sending those fans home happy.
And now let's check in with Allie LaForce with the player of the game. Allie.